Hey, John here. Okay, well, finally, I'm ready to work on my blazer. This is an old Holley carburetor kit, and I have, I just realized I want to show what I'm going to do to get it out. But what I have is I just stuck this in there when I ordered it. Hope you can see it. Looks like there's not enough light on this subject here because of all the light outside. I'll be darned. Well, what it is those are seals. I'll show them again in a minute when I move the camera. Now you can kind of see that. That's what it is. It's a fuel transfer tube, and there's actually, I didn't know if the seals came with it, so I ordered a set of seals, but they could come in handy because that's what it is. The old one is actually bent, so I thought I'd get a new tube, and the seals are leaking like a sieve. And I was going to start it up before I started, you know. I don't know if I'm going to take the carburetor off or if I'm going to just do it up there, you know, with it on the truck. I'll wait, I'll kind of look at it and see. But I'm going to put the seals back in there. I won't need these unless, but that's the last kit. Well, I think the only time I ever had to put a kit on it, I bought the carburetor. When I bought the truck in 1992, now I don't even remember, 90, 91, 92, now I've already forgot. I don't want to lose that. But, the battery had run down. Well, it's been sitting for, I haven't driven it in 2 years. So, if I keep, if you don't drive it at all, then you need to charge the battery every once in a while. But, and sometimes if I do get in it once in a while and get tools out or do this or that. And so I don't know. I don't think I've left anything on, but like lights, inside lights or anything. But anyway, it's not cranking. The lights are still working, so it's not all the way dead. My battery charger's down there. When I open it up, I'll hook it up. Let it charge while I'm working. But last week, I noticed there's a bee. In the last couple of weeks, I've been out here working on other things, and I see bees going up here into the, and it's going in there and not coming back out of the grill. So I thought, dad, you know, it's probably, I think they're wasps, not bees. But yeah, they're wasps. They're those, they're yellow jackets. That's what we call them, yellow jackets. I think they're yellow jacket wasps. Yeah, they have the striped black and yellow tail, but they're much prettier than a bee, like the honeybees that we have around here, flower bees, we don't really. I've never seen a honeycomb around here, but I think they might be what we have normally, or a little bit different than regular honeybees that we have up north and all that. You can hear me that far back, but this year, I've heard about it for 10 years, but this year, I was back in the early spring or late winter, I was out here trying to solder something over there at the desk. And bees kept attacking me, and these were bees, and they were about twice as big as our regular bees, and I think they were those African killer bees they always talk about that got over here, came to Mexico, South America, and then made their way up here. Now they're attacking people all around the country, but I haven't had any now in the summer. So I've already killed 15 of them with that spray, that long-distance spray. Used up a can and a half of that stuff. There's my cap. That's my bug spray cap. I figured I'd find it sooner or later, but anyway, let me get a... get a tool or two. Sometimes I have to use something to... I haven't got my tools out because I don't remember what I'm going to need. Put something in my little side pocket, something to help me open up the... when it hasn't been opened in a while, sometimes it gets hard to open the hood. But anyway, I may have to... I've got a big old sprayer of poison. I think I'll get it handy. I'm ready for them. So I sprayed the whole thing down a week or so ago. So it should be. I don't want it too close to start chasing me. I want to go. Just in the right way, it's really easy to open, but if it's not, it's hard. The It must be sitting just in the wrong room. Plus, it could have rusted up a little bit. Maybe this little chicken bottle will help. There we go. That's what that, I guess you can't see it. I have a camera up there. That's what that is. Brush guard is good for it. Or maybe it's a cow guard. Big and heavy. Got like three, made out of 3-inch pipe. And 1/4-inch plates. So. Thought maybe they had they might have made their nest down. You can't see it, but I wanted to make the best shot for up there. I thought maybe they might have made their nest down in my radiator, in front of my radiator. I've got some cardboard in there. They might like that. I put it. My radiator is really big, and it, in the winter it won't. The heater won't work unless you, even with a 180-degree thermostat in it, brand new one. Anyway, every year I would put cardboard in there, and anyway, I haven't driven it a lot in the last several years, so I actually just left it in there for years. Thought that might be it, and I might want to pull it out, but I don't see any action whatsoever. So I'm just going to go to work, and if they're in there and they come out, then I'll have to spray them. I put on my little poison gloves, but I'm going to have to take them off. Because they sweat my hands like crazy. Put them back over there. I won't have a chance to put them on. If I end up having to fight anything, I won't. Okay. I have another camera that I thought. I rigged me up a camera mount. Let's see. First, I'll unplug it. I've been leaving it plugged in to keep the batteries charged. My other camera here. This is actually it's a slide in, a camera holder that slides in and out of a VR headset, a LA Fire VR headset. I got it at Amazon. It's an Amazon branded one. I'm going to wrap me up a coat hanger on it so I can hang it up there on the hood and aim it down at my work, hopefully. Got two different ways of trying to do that. Instead of trying to set this one on the tripod down there, I thought I would do that. Probably just let them both run. to hook up my battery charger. I have to watch that. My timer's not doesn't work on there, and I don't even know what time it is. Can't see in here, can you? Now it just tells you how long you've been going there. Okay, well, I just have to keep checking on it. Yeah, the timer doesn't go off anymore. It just keeps running no matter where you set it. But it charges good still. Now, I know I'm going to need a few tools. I'll get my little ratchet tray. Get by. Well, it depends. I might get by with my quarter inch set, but I may have to get my 3/8. Just so I could get up there and look. Your can's dirty sometimes. So let's get started, I guess. Okay, let's see. Oh, my charger for that other phone, it'll run down. I've got another drop. Oh, this one's unplugged. Dang it. Well, I'm glad I saw that. Oh, there's a battery indicator on there. It's still good.
Everything's so tiny, I can't really see it anyway. But bulb just keep working since just the other day. Brought it in the house and used it for an extension cord. It has plugs on the side. This is really old. It's older than I am. Actually, this part's newer. It's from the 80s or 70s or whatever. And this one's this other part, I don't know how old it is. It was around the house ever since I was a kid. But I put, it had a metal one, and every time you bumped it, it would break the light. Oh, I think it's, yeah, it's broke. These work pretty good. They don't get as hot. But I don't know why it got broke. It's broke down, it broke loose at the base. That stinks. I do need a little light under there. I had another light bulb over here. But it moves. Ah, it's no good either. I gotta go in the house and get a light bulb now. Yep, should know it. Okay, let me go in the house and get a light bulb. I'll be back. Well, I found another swirly one, but it's shorter. It's probably like a 40-watt one. The other ones break on this, too, so. Turn it the other way, so if it is on, it won't blind me. I don't know which way is which. What's wrong with you? You know, that light might have still worked. I don't have the switch turned on. I use that to turn my air compressor on and off. It always works better when you turn the power strip switch on. Everything works better that way. Couple of end wrenches because I know I'll need a couple. I think I have an idea what to get. Ha. I'm just going to get my whole little thing. Because I'll try to get up there and stay up there. A couple of good rags. I didn't need leather, I used to crawl up the front of it. Thank you. shell when I'm crawling up down the ladder, I'll kick it off of there. I've done it before. Can't remember how I do it. I put some gloves on because it's so bright. I know I won't be able to work the tools very well. I'll have to pick them off when I get to that point. I think this is it. Okay, yeah, I'm fine here. This is recording. Hold up. Yeah, it's still recording. I'm going to get plugged into the one right now. This is the one with the smaller SD card that I see. I tried to start it. Carb right off of 10 minutes in. plug it up and down in here. Now that I moved it, I'll probably need to put it. It doesn't provide a place to put a gasket or anything, but I've got some. Here, I can't find it. Let's see what I can't see. I'm going to see what size it is. I'm going to put that on the map. That new one I bought, they say it works better. That's the thing, I wanted to replace it with the one that said it works better. I wrote to Holley, ordered it from the That's what I decided. I did a bunch of checking first. I got gas in my hands now anyway, so it's really looking at the hit. I just put in gas fuel on this the first time. Oh. I'll just go over here to this camera. Gotta have a drink first. Put this over here in the toolbox so I'll have it. Okay. I said I was going to get a drink, but all I'm doing is getting stuff out. I want the one that's good for gasoline. Well, they're both. I don't think I ever buy any that's not good for gasoline. Silicone gasket maker. I think it's just, oh, one's Parmatex and one's some other brand. Oxygen sensor safe. Actually, I think this is one I didn't buy, and this is one I bought. Matters. They both seem like they're in good shape. The other one comes out a little easier. I think I'll go with it. Actually, the cap is stripped on this one. It doesn't. You gotta be careful. Okay, so there's that one. And where's mine? Put this over here in the light and look at it. Yeah, it's alright. It's got a little skin in the spray paint. I may have another one. Let's see. It's actually in surprisingly good shape. And see if I do have one like that. I'll show my tubes. I already showed the old one over there on the other camera. This would be perfect if I was good at getting around to editing stuff. Oh, I don't have any. I got some interior ones that are no good. Plate gas. Oh wait, there are some new ones down in there. Thought I had some new ones. Ah, that's what I got. But that would not work right. That's probably for the back or some other. It's for another model, is what it's for. Of course, you could cut. If you had to, you could cut out the center, all the other extra parts. I don't think it even matches. Actually, it does match. It might work if in a pinch, but yeah, it's pretty much the same thing. It's the same holes, same everything. No wait. Well, if you turn it over, it probably is. It's not exact. So no, it wouldn't really work. I would rather just use the old one and clean it up. I mean, put a little sealer on it. But yeah, I don't throw away parts, especially new parts. I usually keep, like, if I replace something on my truck or when I drove cars, I would keep. I've tried to replace things before they were completely worn out, and then I would put the old one in there for emergencies, and I've had to use them before, especially fan belts and stuff. So. Now these are extra seals. I didn't know for sure if it came with seals, but it did. And I think I forgot to ask them. I didn't want to. I think I wrote them and it took them like several days to write back. So I didn't want to. This is the new one.
and it's got seals with it. I won't take it out until I get up there, because I'll stick, I'm going to show it up on the other camera, because I probably won't edit these videos. They'll probably end up being separate videos.
So here's the bowl.
Oh, let's see, floating and still moving. Accelerator gasket, that's the actuator for it. That's still working okay. Accelerator pump is still in there. Still in the carburetor. So I'm just going to take it off there. I don't really even need to do any real... I can clean it with my fingers. There's just a couple of little places that had kind of stuck and peeled. Just the tiniest little bit, a couple thousandths off of it. Okay, now what else? Yeah, there's a little bit of that gasket on there. Should move the camera, I guess, but before I'm showing it. But I'm scraping a little bit of gasket off the bowl. It takes so long to re-aim them that it just makes things ridiculous. I think I'll take my air blower and blow it out a little bit. Blow the hole. Whoops, I blow through the holes a little bit. The heat, when the hot weather, you get a lot of moisture. So I think I won't use that. Okay, back up on the hood, I think. Oh, well, I didn't ever get a drop of water. Okay, recording there. Still recording up there. I'll try to be nice and just take out all the dead stuff out there. I'll put it in my YouTube app.
It was only a week.